Good afternoon to everyone. Now, definite integrals. So far, we have learned many things in integral. They are indefinite integrals. Till x is 2.7, we have learned many integration, many type of integrations. They are elementary, algebraic, exponential, and trigonometric, logarithmic functions, integrals we have learned. Those things are indefinite integrals. Now here, we are going to learn about definite integrals. What does mean definite integral or indefinite integral? For example, f of x is equal to x square is the given curve. Consider the curve f of x is equal to x square here. The graph is well known by you all. You all learnt in 10th standard. This is x axis, y axis. This is the origin. This represents y equal to x square and f of x is equal to x square. When we integrate this, we'll have the area indefinitely. From minus infinity to plus infinity, the area covered indefinitely. That is a general case. The area covered with the x-axis between the curve indefinitely is known by the general integral value. When we integrate, integral f of x dx is equal to integral x square dx, that is equal to x cube by 3 plus c. This is the area covered between y equal to x square and between the x axis indefinitely. So this is indefinite integral. Suppose if I want the area between minus 1 to plus 1 and between x axis with the x axis between the curve y equal to x square in between the limits minus 1 to plus 1, I can integrate within the limit. The lower limit is taken always here, minus 1. The upper value limit is taken, the upward and lower limit is denoted lower integral, the upper integral, then integral symbol, then f of x dx. When we apply in this way, when we integrate, we will get x cube by 3, and then the limit minus 1 to plus 1 is substituted here, minus 1 and plus 1. And then by calculating the value, 1 by 3 is taken out. Then substitute the upper limit first, 1 cube, minus of the lower limit, minus 1 cube. That is equal to 1 by 3 into 1 plus 1. Minus 1 cube is minus 1. Minus of minus 1 plus 1, that is equal to 2. That is equal to 2 by 3 square units. This is the particular area between minus 1 to plus 1. The curve covered with the x-axis between minus 1 to plus 1, the area value is 2 by 3 square units. This is definite integral. One particular limit, definite area is calculated. So this type of integral is known as definite integrals. When we, in this definite integral, this indefinite value c will not appear. Instead, we can go with a finite answer. Definite value we can achieve between these two limits is known as definite integral. But here there is no definite value. When we give the limits, we can achieve get a definite value. So this is known as indefinite. Here we have definite integral. So these type of definite integrals we are going to see in this exercise. Here the first fundamental theorem. This is very important. In 1 mark or 2 mark also this will appear in your board. So, learn well and keep in your memory the first fundamental theorem. It may given to 1 mark also. Some of the results will be given. Which of the following is the first fundamental theorem will be the question. Now, if you have first fundamental theorem. If small f of x is a continuous function, it should be continuous between the interval a to x. And the capital F of x is the integral value of small f, the function is converted as t, f of t dt between the limits. when the integral value of this f of t dt is capital F of x, then when we differentiate capital F of x, we'll get the original function. Already we have learned these things in the, when we introduce the complex number. This is a function. F of x is continuous and capital F of x is the integral value of this f of x. Then when we differentiate f dash of x, which will be equal to small f of x. Capital F of x is equal to a t x f of t dt. Then f dash of x yield, which yield f dash of x yields the original function small f of x, is the first fundamental theorem. F of x is a function, continuous function, within the closed interval a comma b. If capital F of x is antiderivative of f of x, capital F of x is its antiderivative, that is integral, antiderivative, then integral a to b f of x dx, when we integrate the function small f of x between the given interval, that value will be equal to f of b minus f of a. When we substitute, that value will be equal to the integrated value from the particular limit of the function f of x dx will be equal to the subtraction of antiderivative value from the upper limit to lower limit, f of b minus f of a. This is the second fundamental theorem. Here a and b represents the lower and upper limits of the definite integral. So the first fundamental theorem is, if f of x is continuous, what is mean continuous? Continuous means the defined interval, the function should not have any break. That means every point within the interval, the function should exist. So if f of x is continuous and capital F of x is equal to integral a to x f of t dt, then f dash of x will yield small f of x. Next, the second fundamental theorem is, let f of x be a continuous function a to b, closed interval a to b, and if capital F of x is an antiderivative, then integral a to b f of x dx will be equal to f of b minus f of a. This is known as second fundamental theorem. Definitely this may be appear in 2 marks also. So learn thoroughly both the first and the second fundamental theorem. Question number 1 in exercise 2.8. Using second fundamental theorem, evaluate integral 0 to 1 e power 2x into dx. Question number 1, integral 0 to 1 e power 2x dx. Always read start from the lower limit and 0 to 1 e power 2x dx. Integral 0 to 1 e power 2x dx. This is simple thing. By using second fundamental theorem, the second fundamental theorem is integral a to b f of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a, capital F of b minus f of a. It's okay. Now first of all, we should integrate this, which is equal to integral e power ax dx is equal to e power ax by a plus c. So now here we have a definite limit. So applying this formula here, it will turn as e power 2x divided by 2 limit 0 to 1. In indefinite integral, we can apply plus c, constant of integration. But here we have a limit between 0 and 1. So apply lower limit here and upper limit here. So integrated here. Then our next move is integral a to b f of dx, f of b minus f of a. This is known as capital F of x. In it, substitute f of b first, then minus f of a. So it will be equal to, taking 1 by 2 out, remaining is e power 2x limit 0 to 1. Now substituting the upper limit and minus the lower limit, this is equal to 1 by 2 into, substitute upper limit instead x, e power 2 into 1, f of b is completed, now minus f of a is 0, e power 2 into 0. Instead x, we are substituting the upper and lower limit, then we are subtracting, which will be equal to 1 by 2 into e power 2 minus 2 into 0, e power 0, e power 0 means it is 1. So e power 0, which is equal to 1 by 2 into e power 2 minus 1. We have a constant value for e power 2, but that is not known by you now. So simply leave it. This will be the answer of the integral 0 to 1 e power 2x dx. So that will be equal to the given question. Integral, therefore, integral 0 to 1 e power 2x dx is equal to 1 by 2 into e power 2 minus 1. This is the area covered between 0 to 1, the e power 2x, the function e power 2x covered between 0 to 1 with the x-axis is the area covered between 0 to 1 with the x-axis of the function f of x is equal to e power 2x is 1 by 2 into e power 2 minus 1. Question number 2, exercise 2.8. Integral 0 to 1 by 4 root of 1 minus 4x dx is given. Using fundamental theorem, evaluate the following. First of all, we should convert this root of 1 minus 4x as power half. That is equal to 0 to 1 by 4, 1 minus 4x power 1 by 2 dx. This is simple to convert a square root as 1 by 2. Now, remainder formula ax plus b whole power n dx. Here we have b minus ax, both are same only. Ax plus b or b plus ax, both are same. For these cases, ax plus b whole power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 into a is the indefinite integral value. Now we can apply the same formula here. For this 1 minus 4x power half dx, which is equal to, after integrating, you should not apply this integral symbol. This lower and upper limit are entered here. The lower limit entered in the lower, upper limit are entered in the upper place. Here, we have 1 minus 4x power n. Ax plus b whole power n formula should be chosen and applied here. So, 1 minus 4x power half plus 1 by 2 plus 1 into the coefficient is multiplied here minus 4. Now look at here, 1 minus 4x to the power, simplifying the power, half plus 1 3 by 2 divided by here also half plus 1 3 by 2 into the coefficient minus 4, the limit applied here 0 to 1 by 4. This is very important. Listen carefully here. Ax plus b whole power n by the same formula. Ax plus b whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1 into the coefficient of x is multiplied minus 4. Here simplifying the power is 3 by 2. Here also we have 3 by 2. Cancelling these two values, 2 and minus 4 will get minus 2. So the denominator will be minus 6. It is taken out. That is equal to minus 1 by 6 into 1 minus 4x whole power 3 by 2 to the power to the limits of 0 to 1 by 4. Now this is easy. By just substituting the values we have integrated, then substitute upper limit minus lower limit, because integral f of x dx between the limit a to b will be equal to the integrator value f of b minus f of a. Now upper limit minus lower limit, that is equal to minus 1 by 6 into, substituting upper limit, 1 minus 4 into 1 by 4, 1 minus 4 into 1 by 4, whole power 3 by 2, minus, now substitute the lower value for x, 1 minus 4 into 0 whole power 3 by 2. And this minus 1 by 6 is common for both terms. That is equal to minus 1 by 6 into, cancelling these two, 1 minus 1 becomes 0. 4 into 1 by 4, 1, 1 minus 1 becomes 0. 0 power 3 by 2, 0. Minus 1 minus 4 into 0, 0. So 1 minus 0 power 3 by 2. Here also we have 1 power 3 by 2, 1. So minus 1 into 1, minus 1. Here minus 1 by 6 into minus 1 by 6 into minus of minus 1. That is equal to minus 1 by 6 into plus 1. Here minus 1 into plus 1, sorry. So minus 1 by 6 into minus 1. That is equal to 1 by 6 is the integral value. Therefore, integral 0 to 1 by 4 root of 1 minus 4x dx will be equal to 1 by 6. This is the value of the second question. Integral 0 to 1 by 4 root of 1 minus 4x dx is equal to 1 by 6. Once again, the same question, listen, 0 to 1 by 4 root of 1 minus 4x dx is equal to 1 minus 4x to the power half. Applying ax plus b whole power n formula, ax plus b whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1. When the coefficient appears, that should be multiplied with the denominator. And then simplifying this, 1 minus 4x power 3 by 2 by minus 6. And then minus 1 by 6 is taken out. 1 minus 4x power 3 by 2 whole power 1 by 4. Now substituting the upper limit minus the lower limit, we will get 0 minus of 1. So here we have minus 1 by 6 into minus 1 is plus 1 by 6. That will be the answer for the second question. Question number 3, exercise 2.8, given as integral 1 to 2 x dx divided by x square plus 1. X dx divided by x square plus 1. For this, we have learned many integral, different type of integrals. Look at here. The numerator we have x, the denominator we have x square plus 1. We can directly go with the formula by adjusting small values. Look at the denominator x square plus 1. Denominator is x square plus 1. Differentiate it, it will be derivative of this one is 2x. The numerator we have simply x dx. So we can think of just multiplying the numerator, we will get the denominator, derivative of the denominator. So for that purpose, I am multiplying the numerator by 2. At the same time, I am dividing the entire value divided by 2. So which is equal to integral 1 to 2. 2x dx divided by x square plus 1 into 1 by 2. Multiply by 1 by 2, the whole value is divisible by 2. So multiply, divide by 2, the value will not be affected. The same value remains here for that we are dividing. Simply multiplying, the value of the given integral will be changed. For avoiding that purpose, just multiply and divide by the same value here. Now look at the function. This is in the form of integral f dash of x divided by f of x into dx. The function in the denominator, its derivative in the numerator. Now we can apply the formula for this one is log of modulus of the denominator function plus the constant of integration for indefinite integral. Now we can apply this value here, the same formula, same integral value here, because we have denominator's derivative in the numerator. So, or we can substitute, then we can go, else we can directly go. Now I'm directly applying the formula. This is in the form of, this is, which implies, this is in the form integral f dash x by f of x into dx. So I can apply the log of modulus of f of x. Therefore, which will be equal to 1 by 2 into log of modulus of the denominator function x square plus 1. Now we have integrated. So apply the limit, lower value limit 1, upper limit is 2. After completing the integration, the integral symbol is removed. Instead, the values of 1 and 2 substituted in the lower and upper places of the integrated value. Now, going with the second fundamental form, integral f of x dA to b f of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. Integral a to b f of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. This is capital F of x. Now substituting f of b value, then minus f of a value, we can reach the required integral value of question number 3. So substituting is equal to 1 by 2 into substituting 2 for x, log of modulus of x square means 2 square, 2 square is 4, 4 plus 1, 5. 4 plus 1 minus log of modulus of substituting 1, 1 square 1, 1 plus 1. 1 by 2 into log 5 minus log 2. The modulus value of 5 is 5, 2 is 2. Now, which will be equal to 1 by 2 log of 5 by 2, because in the property of logarithm we have a quotient rule, in that log a minus log b will be equal to log of a by b. Therefore, this log 5 minus log 2 equal to log 5 by 2. Therefore, integral 1 to 2 x dx divided by x square plus 1 will be equal to half of log of 5 by 2.